Important to the Kazuo Nakamura exhibition. We have Jay Boehmer on the drums. This is his quartet here. We got Russ, Michael, and Kevin, their respective instruments. And maybe just to give you a little thing, I've known Jay for some time. Jay is Kaz's son-in-law. He's married to Elaine Nakamura. Wow, I guess she's a Boehmer now. Or is she a Nakamura?
She's a Nakamura. Oh,
she's a Nakamura. So. Anyway, Jay's a musician. That's his gig. He's been doing that forever. He's talked to me many times that he's done a number of compositions that were inspired by the work of his father-in-law, Kazuo Nakamura. And so I thought this was an opportune time for him to showcase some of his compositions. I don't know exactly how many there are. And I'll turn it over to Jay, and he can tell you more about what we're going to hear. But thanks for coming, and enjoy yourselves.
So I've composed four pieces today that are influenced by the works of Kazuo Nakamura, and then we're going to do a few other compositions by some other artists that I think, some other composers that I think also speak to Kaz's work. The first piece we're going to do, he did a lot of works that were called block structure and inner structure. He wasn't big on names, he was big on the content of the paintings. So we're going to start off with one with some concrete sculptures that he did early in his career. They're about yay high, rectangular in shape, and reminiscent of the painting that's on the back wall here. So if you want to think of one of those towers, but in concrete, maybe on the front lawn. They have a look of space, of distance in them, and makes me think of 2001, A Space Odyssey, that one rectangle hurtling over in space. So we're going to play structure number one for you. Thank you. Blue Reflections. I was thinking of the landscape, not this one particularly, but it could be one similar to that. Kaz used lots of blues and greens in his work, and so they have a similar look to them, but they're all different as well. We're going to try one, just have to remember which painting this is for. This is for one of his string paintings, which we don't have one in the gallery.
I got a little one I'll bring out.
Got a little one? Okay. So I'm assuming he would spend hours putting the string on the canvas, and then usually in parallel lines, and then painting over it. To my eyes, it's got a look of busyness to it, of action, lanes of traffic on the highway. There's probably many ways that you'd want to look at that. So this one is entitled Into Distance.
Very popular, so I'm going to have a little one. And it is string there, by the way. No, at that point, I am.
So is it attached?
Yeah, he would lay the string on it and then sort of paint over it and then just kind of have this particular routine. And they were kind of the antithesis of the block structures. Point, line, form, they were done parallel times.